find something bad, it will shoot you. It's me, Carmine DiStefano, the Bookman. Now, since I already tried to convince you that episodes 1 and 2 are really not that bad, in Star Wars Month, I'm going to be reviewing the works that lead into the trilogy you're all familiar with. Starting with, between the years 2003 and 2005, Cartoon Network, in conjunction with George Lucas, put together a traditional animated 2D series that gave us new villains and the heroics of the Jedi, mostly Anakin Skywalker and Obi-Wan Kenobi, during the wars that led to the fall of the Republic. Basically, it served as filler for all us Star Wars fanatics that couldn't wait to see what would happen in Episode 3. But then in 2008, Warner Brothers, in conjunction with Lucasfilms and George Lucas, created a CGI retelling of this story in the movie theaters that was called The Clone Wars. Now, how would this match up to the rest of the saga? Well, let's take a look at it together, shall we? The movie opens with Jabba the Hutt and his dilemma. His son's been kidnapped. The Jedi want to help him out to open trade routes and help their cause in the war. We notice that Mace Windu's voice sounds kind of familiar.
There is more to this kidnapping than it seems.
Yes, that's Samuel L. Jackson. You know.
And you will know my name is the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon thee.
That's Samuel L. Jackson. We then cut to Master Obi-Wan Kenobi and Jedi Knight Anakin Skywalker leading their troops to battle. And we see right away the awesomeness that is Anakin. Yeah, man. After they clear out the first wave, Anakin and Obi-Wan need reinforcements to continue the battle. And instead, the Jedi Council sends them Padawan Ahsoka Tano. And the answer is... well, she's kind of young and she's not real. She's computer generated, and even if she were real, she's not really human, and...
I understand. Let's get on with it.
Fine! Obi-Wan suggests Anakin take Ahsoka Tano and train her through the battlefield. But Anakin's not really into training Padawans, so they don't seem to get along well right away. But they still have a mission, which is to stop the droid army from attacking their main defense systems. So Anakin and Ahsoka go about their business as Obi-Wan and his troops fight back. So as Anakin and Ahsoka get to the main shield generator, Obi-Wan Kenobi distracts the general by doing his usual schmoozing. Anakin and Ahsoka take down the shield, they defeat the droid army, and they're visited by Yoda, who then tells them they have a new mission, to find Jabba the Hutt's son. Anakin takes on Ahsoka as his apprentice and sends her with him to the planet where Jabba the Hutt's son is being held. Jabba calls for the help of the Jedi or the Sith, since the bounty hunters he sent to find his son have no heads. Obi-Wan goes to Tatooine to talk to Jabba the Hutt himself. Anakin, Ahsoka, and the clone troops fight their way through to... hey, what the hell is that? I didn't know walkers can climb up hilltops. That's sick! With the help of the clone troops, Anakin and Ahsoka fight their way to the top, where they get to a palace. A dark palace. And waiting there is Asajj Ventress, the Sith assassin, and she speaks with Count Dooku, her master, voiced over by, you guessed it, Christopher Lee.
Patience, collect the data I need. You will get your chance of revenge soon enough.
Yes.
There will be no door for men.
That Christopher Lee. Anakin and Ahsoka find Jabba the Hutt's son while Dooku is manipulating Jabba into thinking the Jedi are trying to kill him. In order to make that fact, Ventress then attacks them. She then meets up with Obi-Wan Kenobi, who proceeds to screw with her mind and beat the living shit out of her. She escapes and leaves the Republic with a dilemma. So they send Padme to speak with Jabba's uncle in Coruscant, Zero the Hutt. Zero won't listen to her, so Padme finds her way back into his chambers, where she sees he's plotting with Dooku to usurp Jabba the Hutt. Zero finds her and then locks her up. Back on Tatooine, Anakin meets up with Dooku, who's trying to kill Jabba the Hutt's son. However, Ahsoka has Jabba the Hutt's son, and she's attacked by General Grievous' guardian droids. Anakin gets to Jabba's palace first, then Ahsoka returns with his son alive. He then gets a message from Padme, who brings forth Zero the Hutt, who admits the whole plot with the Sith. Anakin has a sweet exchange with Padme, and then they meet up with Obi-Wan, Yoda, and others. And that's pretty much it. So, what did I think of this movie? I enjoyed it. It's concise, entertaining, and action-packed. The battle scenes are great, the saber fights are excellent, the new characters are really developed well, and you get an idea of the expanded universe, as well as the relationships the Jedi have with their individual clones. Now, from this movie came the running Clone Wars series on the Cartoon Network, which is also really good and a must-see, especially if you're a Star Wars fan. There's only one problem. They keep having short seasons and long gaps between new seasons. Just give me the damn show, will you? But this movie and this series does a lot for the saga itself. This movie and this series leads into the next episode in the saga, Episode 3. But that's next week. Until then, I thank you all for watching. I have more for you soon to come. So stay tuned, take care, have a great day, and may the Force be with you.